Everyone, today I am going to start with the last topic of principles of electronic communication, that is microwave and microstrip patch antennas. First we'll go through the basic concepts of microwave antenna. So a microwave antenna is designed to receive and transmit electromagnetic radiation with wavelengths between infrared radiation and radio waves. Microwave radiation can travel through the atmosphere or space, and the antennas pick up those signals in broadband, a specified band or signal single frequency. The technology comes in many sizes and shapes, linking voice and data wireless transmissions for applications such as radar, radio astronomy and telephone networks. One type of common microwave antenna is used in cell phones. This mobile communications device transmit in a microwave frequency by radiating energy in every direction. A base station receives the transmission and sends it through relays in a telecommunications network until it reaches its destination. Signals can include data that carry voice, video and text. A microwave antenna is defined as a device for physical transmission and is used for broadcasting microwave transmissions between two or more places. Microwave antennas are known for broadcasting transmissions between two or more locations, making them crucial elements for any microwave network. Now we'll talk about the types of microwave antenna. So microwave antenna are divided into two types, dish antenna and horn antenna. We'll discuss about this one by one. The first we'll discuss about dish antenna. So dish antennas are the microwave antennas which use a parabolic reflectors. Dish antenna means a parabolic shaped antenna which is designed to receive television broadcast or other electronic communication signals. Parabolic reflectors are microwave antennas. A parabolic reflector dish or mirror is a device that is used to collect or project energy such as electromagnetic waves. The frequency range used for the application of parabolic reflector antennas is above 1 MHz. These antennas are widely used for radio and wireless applications. Now we'll talk about the operation of dish antenna. The standard definition of a parabola is locus of a point, which moves in such a way that its distance from the fixed point, which is called as focus, plus its distance from a straight line, which is called as directrix, is constant. The following figure shows the geometry of parabolic reflector. Here the point F is the focus and V is the vertex. The line joining F and V is the axis of symmetry. PQ are the reflected rays, where L is the line directrix on which the reflected points lie. Hence, as per the above definition, the distance between F and L lie constant with respect to the waves being focused. The reflected wave forms a collimated wave front out of the parabolic shape. The ratio of focal length to aperture ratio size, that is F by D, known as F over D ratio, is an important parameter of parabolic reflector. Its value varies from 0.25 to 0.50. The law of reflection states that the angle of incidence and the angle of reflection are equal. This law, when used along with a parabola, it helps the beam to focus. The shape of the parabola when used for the purpose of reflection of waves exhibits some properties of the parabola, which are helpful for building an antenna using the waves reflected. Now we'll talk about the construction of dish antenna. So if a parabolic reflector antenna is used for transmitting a signal, the signal from the feed comes out of a dipole or a horn antenna to focus the wave onto the parabola. It means that the waves come out of the focal point and strike the paraboloidal reflector. This wave now gets reflected as collimated wavefront to get transmitted. The same antenna is used as a receiver. So when the electromagnetic wave hits the shape of a parabola, the wave gets reflected onto the feed point. The dipole of the horn antenna, which acts as a receiver antenna at this feed, receives this signal to convert it into electric signal and forwards it to the receiver circuitry. The gain of the parabola is a function of aperture ratio, that is d by lambda. The effective radiated power, ERP, of an antenna is the multiplication of the input power fed to the antenna and its power gain. Usually a waveguide horn antenna is used as a feed radiator for the paraboloid reflector antenna. Along with this technique, we have another type of feed given to the paraboloid reflector antenna called as cassegrain feed. Now we'll talk about the Cassegrain feed. So Cassegrain is another type of feed given to the reflector antenna. In this type, the feed is located at the vertex of the paraboloid, unlike in the parabolic reflector. A convex shaped reflector which acts as a paraboloid is placed opposite to the feed of the antenna. It is also known as secondary hyperboloid reflector or sub-reflector. It is placed such that it is placed in such a way that its one of the foci coincides with the focus of the paraboloid, and thus the wave gets reflected twice in. Now let's just take a minute and try to answer these questions. Cassegrain antennas cannot be used in radio telescopes, whether it is true or false. In which of the following secondary reflector is convex and law of reflection states that angle of incidence is dash to angle of reflection? I hope you got the answers. So Cassegrain antennas cannot be used in radio telescope. So is this false? In which of the following secondary reflector is convex, that is in Cassegrain? And law of reflection states that angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. So these are the answers. Let's just move forward and talk about horn antenna. So to improve the radiation efficiency and directivity of the beam, the waveguide should be provided with an extended aperture to make the abrupt discontinuity of the wave into a gradual transformation, so that all the energy in the forward direction gets radiated. This can be termed as flaring. Now this can be done using a horn antenna. The operational frequency range of a horn antenna is around 300 MHz to 30 GHz. This antenna works in ultra high frequency and super high frequency ranges. Now we'll talk about the construction of horn antenna. The energy of the beam when slowly transformed into radiation, the losses are reduced and the focusing of the beam improves. A horn antenna may be considered as a flared out waveguide by which the directivity is improved and the diffraction is reduced. The image shows the model of a horn antenna. The flaring of the horn is clearly shown here. Horn antennas have very little loss, so the directivity of a horn is roughly equal to its gain. So there are several horn configurations, out of which three configurations are most commonly used. So first one is a sectoral horn. Second one is a pyramidal horn, and third one is a conical horn. So in sectoral horn, type of horn antenna, flares out is in only one direction. Flaring in the direction of electric vector produces the sectoral E-plane horn. Similarly, flaring in the direction of magnetic vector produces the sectoral H-plane horn. Next is a pyramidal horn. So this type of horn antenna has flaring on both sides. So if flaring is done on both the sides of E and H walls of a rectangular waveguide, then pyramidal horn antenna is produced. This antenna has the shape of a truncated pyramid. Lastly, we have a conical horn. So when the walls of a circular waveguide are flared, it is known as conical horn. And this is a logical termination of a circular waveguide. Now we'll talk about the radiation pattern of horn antenna. So the radiation pattern of a horn antenna is a spherical wavefront. The following figure shows the radiation pattern of horn antenna. The wave radiates from the aperture, minimizing the diffraction of waves. The flaring keeps the beam focused. The radiated beam has high directivity and horn antennas have very little loss, so the directivity of horn is equal to its gain. Lastly, we'll talk about the microstrip patch antenna. So a microstrip antenna, which is also called as patch antenna or pintered antenna, is an antenna which is primarily a two-dimensional flood structure. Microstrip antennas are low-profile antennas. A metal patch mounted at a ground level with a dielectric material in between constitutes a microstrip or patch antenna. These are very low-size antennas having low radiation. The patch antennas are popular for low-profile applications at frequencies above 100 MHz. An antenna that is formed by etching out a patch of conductive material on a dielectric surface is known as patch antenna. The dielectric material is mounted on a ground plane where the ground plane supports the whole structure. Also, the excitation to the antenna is provided using feed lines connected through the patch. I will talk about the construction of microstrip patch antenna. So, microstrip antenna consists of a very thin metallic strip placed on a ground plane with a dielectric material in between. The radiating element and the feed lines are placed by the process of photo etching on the dielectric material. Usually the patch or microstrip is chosen to be square, circular, rectangular in shape for the ease of analysis and fabrication. Here the following figure shows the microstrip or patch antenna. The length of the metal patch is lambda by 2. When the antenna is excited, the waves generated within the dielectric undergo reflections and the energy is radiated from the edges of the metal patch, which is very low. Now we'll talk about the radiation pattern of microstrip patch antenna. The radiation pattern of microstrip or patch antenna is broad. It has low radiation power and narrow frequency bandwidth. It has lesser directivity. To have a greater directivity, an array can be formed by using these patch antennas. Now let's just take a minute and try to answer these questions. Which of the antenna is mainly used for broadband signals? In which of the following bands the horn antenna operates? And in microstrip antenna, the patch and the feed line is photo etched on dielectric substrate, whether it is true or false. I hope you got the answer. So which of the antennas mainly used for broadband signal, that is horn antenna? In which of the following bands the horn antenna operates, it is UHF and SHF. And in microstrip antenna, the patch and the feed line is photoetched on dielectric substrate. So this is true. So you got the answers. I hope you have understood the concept of microwave and microstrip patch antennas. Thank you.